My Design Rules is sponsored by Capitec. Better never rests. Last week on My Design Rules, our four design duos were revealed and they chose their apartments and were given the themes that will inspire their designs. Team Water is Tia and Zweli from Richards Bay. Team Air is Joshua and Amy, who were paired up on the show. Team Earth is brothers from Joburg, Sipe and Bapalele. And Team Fire is Hannah and Keaton from the Mother City. Now their journey begins as they reimagine and reinvent four apartments in a heritage building in Cape Town's sought-after suburb of Sea Point. Before the rebuilding begins, it starts with breaking down. As the teams plan the layout of their apartments, some of the old interior walls must go to make space for their vision. And for Team Earth, it's all about dreaming big.
It's demolition day, looking forward to breaking some walls out of all my stress out of that wall. Bang!
Ah, my gents,
brother,
how are we doing?
Good yourself, man.
Oh, fantastic. You look incredible in your work here, right?
Shout out to Deco for the fit.
Yeah, it looks like it was absolutely made for you, but looking at this, it seems like textures are here, we've got colors here, we've got everything. Are these final decisions that you've made, or are we still figuring it out as we go?
So yeah, we've got amazing fabrics here, different textures, going from some velvets, also like pop of color there and there, but yeah, it's looking amazing.
Take me through what's actually happening, man.
So this is the floor plan that we created, the flow and our doors, we're changing some of them. And also they're doing a facelift on the front facade of the house, you know? Yeah. So we kind of incorporate that in the kitchen, in the bathrooms, as well as the living room, you know?
I love the fact that it's open plan, of course. So this seems like an entertainer's delight here, especially if you're someone that's loving the social scene.
For sure.
And it does seem like there's a great flow and a story to this, but easier said than done, boys.
Sure. Damn sure.
And today I think it's all about knocking, chopping and demolition. So
it's good luck, guys.
Thanks, man.
It's not longer going to be a two-bedroom apartment, it's going to be one. So there's a number of walls that you're keeping, then most of the walls are cut, and they got to go.
It was really dope blowing off some steam, you know, just breaking down those walls. You know how it would be, break down walls.
The brothers are breaking through more than just physical walls, having launched their own company together.
Bapalele and I are interior designers, and we are the co-founders of Masana Interior Architects, and that's our baby.
It was just always in the conversation of like, what can we do together, you know? I knew that if there was anyone like that was strong enough to kind of handle like the idea that I have, it would be my brother, and the rest was history.
Creative flair and entrepreneurial spirit runs in the family, with their mother Nozuko being an experienced clothing designer.
For them it was not difficult to be creative because it's in their genes. Sipe, yes, he's talking too much. He is good in marketing. I knew that he's going to market, but in studying, Bapalele was a genius.
I am the more, I would say, more technical guy. He's more conceptual, but we can reverse those roles at any given point in time in the business. We work amazingly together. I can't point anything that
doesn't
would be
get better than this.
Doesn't get better than this at all.
My mom is a designer and my dad is a soldier. So just being raised up in a home whereby you really like allowed to be who you are, we gravitated towards art a lot. Started drawing like 4 years old. Our mother is the love and passion behind the hard work that we put in, the hours, the risks that we take. I remember one day, you know, I was talking to her and I was like, hey mom, you know, I'm just doing this for home. And she was just like, no, you're not doing this for home. You're doing this for the whole nation, if not the world, you know.
If now they are at their age, they are doing this, in future, they'll give bread to other people and develop other people.
Our mother is still quite a big influence in terms of the decisions that we make. We've always been planning on expansion, which is, apart from the service, which is interior design, creating product. You know, we're big on product design. We've created a range in her name also.
we made it bold, African, like a lot of wood, curved shapes, and just with the character, you know, she's a Xhosa woman. So we put that into the design that, you know, it's a statement piece.
Today, it's all about celebration as they honor their mom on her birthday, along with their sister Onako and older brother Mtunzi.
Family is everything to us. Everything that we aspire to do, how we move, how we carry ourselves.
I feel like we were raised with a lot of love. We might not have had a lot of things, but like the love, the house was very warm, full of laughter. And that's why, like, in everything that we do, we have to do it out of love.
They understand each other, you know, so they know each other's weaknesses and each other's strengths, you know. So in the near future, I'm sure, you know, whatever it is that they're gonna do, whatever field they're gonna go in this industry, you know, they will be successful.
We entered My Design Rule because we're very competitive by nature, all right? So we thought the opportunity would just bring so much into the business, growth, and just expanding our name. We think we are the new big thing.
We are currently building our parents a house in the Eastern Cape, give them a nice retiring home.
The thought has been in our heads for quite a while now.
Winning My Design Rules will definitely help us finish up the project that we're building for the parents.
Having that extra amount of money will push us to do further than what we're planning to do right now. I don't know. But
it's just like really a great way to say thank you for all the hard work, standing together and just striving until this point. You know, we are products of what they've invested in us, you know.
They're so dedicated, really. When you're training a child, it's like you're not training the child for you alone. You're training the child for the world. I'm really proud of you guys.
Thank you. Their ambition to succeed is strengthened by the support of their mother. And because better never rests, Capitec Business is providing all our duos with some much-needed assistance.
The Capitec headquarters are really cool. It's very modern with touches of industrialism. I mean, it's a vibe. I love it.
So the fact that they've got a lot of play with color in the building itself, it makes it very playful. It makes it a very friendly work environment.
And then also the use of lighting, like how it almost like illuminates the space and lights up on the curves. I think we can take some inspiration also into our designs.
Speaking of contestants, how's it going? How are you doing?
So lovely to meet you. Lovely to meet you.
Well, contestants, officially, let me introduce you to Asha Patel. She is the head of brand and communications right here at Capitec Business.
So welcome to Capitec Business. We'd like to invite you to open your Capitec app on your Samsung phones, and you'll notice that we've loaded your account with 250,000 Rand.
250,000 Rand?
I mean,
what? No, that's gonna go a long way.
How many
zeros is that?
Four.
Four?
I think. You know, we had math lit, so what do we know?
Make the right choices. You get an additional 1% cash back with every swipe. So that adds an additional 2,500 Rand to your account.
No, we feel amazing about that. That means, you know, we can go a little bit, you know, higher than expected, I guess. We can push the budget a little bit, you know.
Now, on top of this, as your banking partner, Capitec Business wants you to add value to your apartments. You need to stand out from your fellow designer. We want you to be creative with the materials that you choose and also be forward-thinking, but practical at the same time. Now we know that first impressions are always important, but if you get these choices right, you could be adding value and seeing your apartment grow in time to come.
We also partnered with CTM and are giving you access to 100,000 Rand in credit to furnish your apartment with affordable luxury.
It's a lot of money and it's definitely gonna help us.
Yeah.
We need the decor,
but
also I need a budget so you don't waste it all, please.
The budget. It's a joint effort.
Absolutely.
He has great ideas. She makes them work.
Oh, well, thank you so much, Usher. And a reminder to you that this is not just about design. This is about creating careers, because better never rests. And our Capitec business is building a better future for our winning duo with a grand prize of 300,000 Rand for our best design and 100,000 Rand for the team that impresses you.
Let's go.
Thank you.
Thank you.
Winning the 300,000 from Capitec could mean a lot to us, you know, for our careers, for our personal lives.
When we win the show, the money is going to go back to our business, help take care of things at home, because we're also building our parents' house. It'll be good for that, like a lot. But yeah, it's just really like upskilling our business and making sure going forward, we're just more equipped with everything that was going to be happening after the show.
Next up, private property CEO Theo Mseka shares some insights into what makes Sea Point one of the most sought-after suburbs in Cape Town. Plus, you stand a chance to win 5,000 Rand in cash from Capitec.
Hannah, Keaton, how's it going?
Hey.
How are you guys doing? It looks like stuff is happening at least, yeah?
Indeed, we have got lots of color happening on this wall, which is a sign of things to come. Yeah, we're playing with natural materials and kind of finding our way.
Yeah, and we're trying to like get all the elements that we're gonna add. Everything at like links to fire, because I mean glass gets made out of fire.
Steel
gets made out of fire. So
wood.
I see what you did there.
Trying to, everything needs to have a story that links to fire. So I think there's a lot we can do with this.
What do you have in terms of knocking things down?
We're gonna knock down a wall here today and build things up, kind of create new passageways through the bedroom to the bathroom. So
we're making two arches here to bring in more light coming from like this side. So
I think we're digging what we're doing.
100%.
Also wanting to, of course, emphasize our fire. This, it's kind of going to be the centerpiece of the home, which is so fitting with our theme. So everything kind of connects to it.
It's going to be the core of everything that happens around the space. So now we're very excited to see the vision come to life.
My name is Hannah Joy Morgan. I'm 24 years old and I'm a multimedia designer. As a young girl, I always saw my mom rearranging the rooms in our house, and it so inspired me the way that just by reshuffling small things, a room could have new life. From really young, I knew I wanted to study design. Already at 15, I was researching universities to go to and found the degree at Stellenbosch University, Visual Communication Design, that just encompassed so many of my passions, everything from animation to illustration. I feel like I'm always observing and taking in the world around me, and I'm constantly inspired by life. Art galleries are such an amazing space to get inspiration because they are always changing and reflecting what designers and artists are thinking and feeling. Art is always a reflection of the times, and so I go there to get inspiration for what I can do in my own work, and it's just a wonderful way to spend my time. Interior design has always been a great passion and curiosity of mine that I've done in my personal life but never explored professionally. But entering My Design Rules has been the chance to do just that. I met Keaton through work and already then sussed him out and knew he was perfect for the show. We both had a shared love for interiors, and I've seen his work ethic, I've seen how he gets a job done and with so much style and elegance. So he's the perfect teammate for me. I think the main challenge Keaton and I will have in this competition is lacking the technical abilities or just the technical kind of know-how of how space and interiors work, but we are not lacking in taste and vision, and I'm confident we'll bring that all to the party. My love for thrifting started really young. I can remember going to farmers markets with my gran and looking through all these secondhand treasures, and it was just so exciting. And then that kind of trickled into more the fashion space and just sourcing the most incredible like coats from Europe and pants that I could never afford on my own, I could now find secondhand. And it's so sustainable as well to purchase things secondhand, and these clothes with a story that you now get to continue. It's just something something that I love and I think it's so important. I love to bring pieces of history into the modern day, and I think through design you can do that. You can imagine a new life for an old thing, and so thrifting really enables that, and it's absolutely something that I want to do on this show. Winning the show would be such a vote of confidence in my career change into interior design. I think if this is just the starting point, I can't even imagine what I can do with more experience and time, and I am so excited for the journey ahead.
Bringing property expertise to the table is Theom Seka, CEO at Private Property, who have been helping South Africans buy and sell homes for more than 25 years.
Theo, I know you love renovating as much as we do, but why is property in South Africa still a solid investment?
It's a fantastic investment, especially in places like Cape Town. You know, property has increased in value more than 30% over the last 5 years, depending on the area that you are looking to invest in.
Now, we are renovating and remodeling a heritage building. How does that set this thing apart from, let's say, other apartment blocks out there?
Yeah, so heritage buildings have got fantastic bones. They've got all this history, you know, the heritage that comes with them. I personally own a heritage home, which is a wonderful place to call home. Fantastic structural walls, you know, they just don't build them like they used to many, many years ago. And ultimately, you can do a lot more with these homes, having that older feel on the outside, but you can modernize a little bit on the inside, so you get the best of both worlds.
Well, look, our design duos are definitely going to be excited, to say the least, about the changes that are going on in this old lady. So would you like to meet them?
Fantastic, let's go.
Let's head through. Yeah. What's up? How are we doing, everybody? Good morning, good morning. So listen, contestants, I really want you to succeed, and I want to have your back in these challenges. So with that being said, I thought let's arrange a coffee date with Theo.
I'm an expert at C-Points, so I'm looking forward to showing you around. Thank you very much.
Cheers, bro. See you later. Thank you.
So we're talking about property investment, and especially in an area like C-Points, you need to invest yourself into the community as well, because there's so much heritage and things you can learn around the area that you're investing in.
Since we're working with a heritage building, what are ways we can kind of carry that history through and into our designs in a modern way?
The building itself has got such character. Massive, strong walls, big columns, focus on the structure. You can always change the couch, you can always repaint, but the raw foundations that you're putting down, that needs to be of great quality, as solid as you can, and you might gut internally and modernize some parts, but have a section where it keeps some of that heritage. Because the reality is, buildings are not made the way that they used to. That building is super old and has stood the test of time. You know, the Cape Town storms and the wind, it's still solid. So take advantage of the heritage of the building.
It is so exciting getting to meet the CEO of Private Property. He's given us so much of his knowledge and just helped us further our careers and our future in property.
Theo gave us a lot of insight, especially regarding property in and around C-Point. You know, he explained a lot about how the market has grown in the last 5 years, almost with 30%. So it was just interesting to kind of like tap into his mind.
Heritage has been like the first thing, you know, from word go that we had to like kind of focus on. But obviously I really liked his perspective of it and how he laid it down, like, you know, because, you know, you travel the world, but why come to Cape Town if you're going to take away the essence of Cape Town when it comes to property? So the heritage of it is very like important to be like kept there. So those are the key points that we kind of learned about it.
Next up, we get to know Richards Bay locals and interior design colleagues Tia and Zweli from Team Water. Plus, you stand a chance to win 5,000 Rand in cash from Capitec.
How much can you endure? This is how much we can. Caesarstone, designed to endure life.
Capitec. Do it all on our app, just like that.
We are finally breaking down our walls.
Yeah, guys, so obviously we're talking about the theme being wind, which is incredible. What are you going to be doing with this and how are you going to relate this to the actual design of the home?
Well, when we first picked the wind theme, I was shock horror because it was grey. So we were thinking, okay, wind, like the breath of air, the first breath, you know, and there's movement to it. There's hues of the sky of dawn or dusk.
So you're bringing that association of what wind brings with it as an element.
Exactly.
I like that. Pretty smart. Nice. And also noticing now the fact that you are knocking out quite a bit in this home. What's the reason for that?
Yeah, absolutely. So in the olden days, we used to live in all the services should be together, the kitchen and the lounge should be separated. And it's not modern anymore. Yeah, in modern days, you want to bring things closer. You want to have your family closer to you. And also the services, is we've got modern technology. So we are able to move these things around. And yeah, the way to do this is obviously knock down walls and open the space.
We're breaking down the bathroom walls and the kitchen walls to open up the kitchen space a bit. And we're breaking down the wall between the two bedrooms.
Yes.
Ooh, shaka.
Yeah.
So it's demolition day and we're really excited. There's quite a few walls that we need to break down.
How are you feeling so far, guys?
We're really looking forward to the next stages of our demolition and just putting our color palettes together and yeah, progressing in our designs.
Obviously, you're getting water. We had a few choices. You didn't get to decide, though. It was kind of like a roulette. Are you happy with the theme that you've landed on, though?
Not really happy with the blue or green theme, but we have to make it work. And the thing with blue and green is that it's one of those colors that if you make it work, it really can propel you to a different level in terms of the design.
Yeah. So it just depends how we play with it, but we're willing to take up the challenge. And I mean, it's obviously not one of our normal color palettes that we'd work with, but yeah, we're ready for the challenge.
We're ready for the challenge.
It's really exciting to be demolishing these walls. A lot of adrenaline, you know, like the dust, you know, this is the fun part, you know, of like the whole challenge, you know, like getting to break down our own walls is really amazing.
Back home in Richards Bay along the KZN coastline, Tia and Zweli work together at an architectural firm and were encouraged to enter by their boss, who believes they have what it takes to win.
I'm an architectural technologist at TJ Architects International. In grade 10, we're at a job shadow as a part of our life orientation program at Richards Bay Christian School. And I reached out to Greg Hendricks as he was a well-known architect in Richards Bay.
It was through job shadowing Greg that Tia was inspired to become an architect. And it's here where she met her team partner, interior designer Zweli.
What got me into interior design was actually watching Top Billing and watching Win a Home, the Win a Home show. I liked it so much because it sort of like showed me that the background of interior design, what really goes into like making those spaces and those homes beautiful. I was just inspired.
We encourage him to enter the competition because it gives you opportunity just to really explore and do things that you want to do as a designer. Competitions allow you just to be free and let go. For them, it's a really amazing opportunity and really pleased and proud of them.
My background allows me to think that functionality is the most important thing when designing a concept or a floor plan, and thereafter should aesthetics follow. I like being accurate and I love like being able to dimension and measure something and make sure that it is exact.
When it comes to design, I think my strength is the fact that I approach design philosophically. I like to put my soul into it. A good space can make you feel confident in yourself, waking up in the morning, and it makes you ready to face any challenge that the day has to throw at you. You know, like even like coming back home to that warm and good space, it makes you feel good. So that's what, you know, we're trying to achieve as interior designers.
Working together daily gives the duo a unique edge in the competition. And growing up next to the ocean is the perfect inspiration for their theme, which is water.
I think the thing that we found like the most exciting and also very challenging is being on site and having to make like quick decisions. I'm normally very indecisive and it can take me hours to figure out what I actually want. But when the build is waiting for you and you have to give out the designs, it has to happen now. And that's been quite a challenge for us, but I think we're handling it pretty well. We're both very bold people and we want to show our personalities in our design. And we also really love a nice aesthetic, like something that looks and feels good is definitely what we're trying to achieve.
It's a lot of color, a lot of texture, a lot of like organic shades, you know, just to like tie in with that theme of water.
And then what do you suggest? Which one do we order?
I think we should order long shower traps.
I think our biggest competition would be the brothers, and that's because they came second in the challenge. However, don't agree necessarily with their style and their color choice in the CTM challenge. It was very gray and flat, and I think we're a lot more bold and want to bring color. So I think that's what separates us.
We're not too worried about Josh, Amy, Keaton, and Hannah. I'm just not too worried about those guys.
Being here today and having this amazing ocean view behind us has definitely helped us solidify our color palettes and our themes and make it all come together. It's all making sense.
Yeah.
Joshua and Amy's working relationship is still in its infancy, having only met for the first time on the show. So they grab every moment to build their understanding of each other's design process.
When it reaches a point where it's just not coming right and I just can't work it out, I do crack. I crack a bit. Handling stress, I've got to take a breather.
I've got my way to do things. Amy's got her way to do things. And it's finding that dynamic between the two of us that will either give us advantage in this game or a disadvantage. I think we should get designing.
Yeah, let's get going.
Up next, the duos travel out to the Clane Karoo to experience a heritage home that's been reimagined into a designer masterpiece. Plus, find out how you could be the winner of 5,000 Rand in cash from Capitec.
Who says no to a cappuccino? Jacobs, Wunderbar.
Renowned architect Greg Truen has a passion for small town life, and his decision to invest here is part of a growing trend among South Africans to seek out a simpler existence closer to nature.
I found it about 7-8 years ago on an estate agent's posting, and I thought to myself, it doesn't make sense. It's such an extraordinary building. And I came out and looked at it, and it really was extraordinary. And that was the beginning of a long journey. Really, this kind of unusually diverse, complex, beautiful, extraordinary landscape is the most important part of it for me. You know, we come here and we feel lucky.
Taking a break from sight, the duos head out on a road trip to the Clane Karoo to experience a local and international award-winning heritage home brought to life by Greg and the team at Sayota.
Hi, everyone.
Hello.
Welcome to Biffelstif Farm. My name is Greg and this is Jaco. We're both architects. We've been working on this project for many years. The farm dates back to the 1750s, and there are a series of buildings that have been built on it over time. The very iconic pink wine store in the back, which everybody knows, the main house sitting here. So welcome, great to have you here. You guys are welcome to have a look around and ask any questions that you might have about the process.
Thank you.
Let's go this way.
Yeah. Our first impression of Biffelstif Farm is wow.
It's such an amazing and tranquil space.
I mean, it really is just magnificent.
Yeah, the early morning has definitely been worth it.
These babies are amazing. And also, I like the color of it.
and that earthiness in it, that natural, you know, feel. Just like three of these, like imagine this right next to as you come in, you know? And then you have that invincible door that has that arch.
It's not like this one, it's so cool.
I was thinking of that. You probably think of that Playboy logo.
Nah, not that.
Tell me the story about this piece of history.
That's the manger, a feeding trough.
And the cow would stand here and it was probably tied onto one of those hooks or something, and somebody would be sitting here milking it.
People will often just solve a problem practically and try and make it look good. But what you end up with something that's quite generic and potentially quite soulless and doesn't have a kind of a backstory. It's important that that story comes through. You want to kind of see the way people touched this building in their journey with it.
Joshua and Amy's approach to their design theme draws similarities to the Biffelstrift home, making use of neutral tones and movement through the spaces.
We are lucky enough to be the only contestants that have most of those arches.
Yeah.
Which is a good thing. But how do you think we can incorporate more heritage?
You know, buildings are all built in a particular time, and in that particular time, people do things in particular ways.
You have to understand the technology of it.
Yeah, such a good point, because, you know, the technology of this building was such a key determinant for us about what kind of contemporary moves we made, because we really kind of tried to unpack the way this building was built.
And if you understand that, then you understand how you can change the building without losing the essence of it.
It's quite exciting to see that I can apply the same sort of methodology that they've got implemented in here into our own apartment that's also heritage.
Amy wasn't able to go on the road trip, so Joshua captured every detail on his Samsung phone to take back and analyze with her.
When Amy is not with me, I think we miss that sort of perspective between each other. How we can actually see each other's vision of certain design elements and design principles being applied to furniture and to the actual structure of the building.
Across the road from the farmhouse lies the famous pink duplex, which has caught the eyes of Hannah and Keaton, who find similarities to their design theme.
Our theme for our apartment is fire. Fire comes in so many different shades of color, and we really want to incorporate a shade of pink, especially into our lounge. Tell us about the texture, how you guys decided on this, their story.
There's an architect called Luis Barragan. I think he worked in the early 1900s, and a lot of his buildings have these pink lime painted finishes. So the pink comes from a little insect called the cochineal.
Cochineal, oh wow.
Yes.
Fire can seem like such an overwhelming theme, but I think even just seeing the pink used in a tone that just appeals so much to us and our kind of playful, quirky personalities, and is such an iconic building, I think just shows that it works.
There is something timeless about, you know, the look of it. Fire is wild, so we might as well lean into it.
There's like a wash to it. Is that a specific brush you use? Like, what is the technique to apply it?
You don't really paint lime. You put it on with a very wide brush.
Would we need to prep the walls at all for that?
Lime sits quite well on raw, porous things. Normal plaster bricks will take it, but the first layers must almost be like water. It goes into the brick, and then you build up layers onto that where you make the lime more and more.
The space has just made me feel so zen, and like I want to bring that into our apartment, that earthy feel.
Hi guys.
Sure.
So what do you think?
Oh man, where do we start?
Lovely house, lovely house.
Beautiful house. It's just interesting layout. You can tell that you've traveled Africa a lot. So there's a lot of that in being embraced, you know, and obviously the culture around the heritage that's been kept, you know.
Since the house has been around since the 1750s, throughout the years, probably there's been modifications that have been made. What was kept and what was preserved in terms of heritage of the building?
So a lot of the interventions were fixing things like floors that had been damaged over the years, but using the right appropriate materials that people would have used. The whole building had had cement plaster put on over the years, so that all came off and we put lime plaster on.
It also like just keeps that feel.
Earthy layer to it.
Yeah. That's such an interesting point, earthiness, because the building's made out of the clay that was found on the farm.
Really? Wow.
So you can actually see the original clay construction, and you can see how they put these temporary lintels in so that they could then cut out the actual openings. There's also kind of storytelling in the building, and that's really cool.
The actual textures, you know, like the wall finishes, just not being too smooth, using like worn out material just brings like a certain character into the space, and I found that amazing. And how he, you know, they've done it here, it's mind blowing.
This is a very much a contemporary kitchen. We wanted it again to kind of reflect the heritage of the materiality of this building.
Oh,
so,
yeah.
You know, we've got these stone floors and you see the stone colors and textures coming through in the terrazzo. And then the timber panels on the doors as well. It's a very functional space, you know, it operates in lots of different ways for us. That idea of taking a space and letting it operate in different modes is actually
multifunctional
quite a good
space.
Idea.
We are using the exact same color palette, the neutral tans and browns and kind of beigeish colors. We are applying oak also in our kitchen and our floors, which is quite a testament of what's happening over here.
Sometimes people like they've got like a authentic, natural older space, and then they overdo it with all the like older mid-century art, and then I feel like there's such a well balance between the classic and the new with modern elements.
There's a clear distinction between the new stuff and the old stuff.
Exactly.
And they're not trying to imitate each other.
No, they just somehow naturally complement each other.
The spike in interest for properties in smaller towns is confirmed by Theo Mseka and his team at Private Property, based on their analysis of the market.
Following COVID, we've seen a trend of people living in cities scaling down to have smaller two-bedroom units, etc., and buying bigger, small holdings or properties outside of the cities. You know, within 2 hours driving of most major cities, you've got wonderful towns that have now started to see a rise in the property prices as the demand from people from the cities are moving in. And properties that were bought in 2020 are now 70% up at resale value just 4 years later. There's also the phenomenon of working from home. So individuals are now in a position to be able to come to the city for their 2 or 3 days in the office, and then you still get the luxury of living in a much bigger space just outside of the city. So browse privateproperty.co.za to find an investment property in a smaller town around South Africa.
Up next, after being inspired on their road trip, the duos go shopping and we learn more about some of the challenges that come with restoring a heritage building. Plus, stay tuned to find out how you can win 5,000 Rand with Capitec.
Whether you're looking for a lock up and go, or a settle down and grow, an office for your booming business, or a safe haven, we have a space for you.
Stand a chance to win a weekend away in the winning apartment with Buco. Dial *120*62800# and follow the prompts to enter. Begin with Buco. Restoring a heritage building comes with its own set of challenges. To get the drainage up to standard requires modern techniques and the right supplier. Enter the experts from Marley Piping.
Well, Duncan, I don't know how else to put this, but we've got a stinking situation here. We've got the professional here, so bud, help me out. What's happening?
What we have here is the main sewer line, which is blocked.
Yeah.
So this sewer line runs all along the side of the property and picks up all the drainage, all the sewer. So once we open, we can then see what we're up against. But what we're looking at is a blocked main sewer line.
We're talking about a building that's close to 95 years old, so nothing much has been done since then. And I think for many people that are looking at renovating, is this the kind of thing that you could expect from the world of plumbing?
Let me take you around to the back and I'll show you how it was done in those days, and then I can give some insight on how we would do things nowadays.
Love it, let's hit it.
Cool. Raul, who we have here is Leon and Johan from Mali.
How's it, gents?
Gents, it's good meeting you. Thank you for being a part of this incredible project. And I gotta say, she's an old lady, 95 years old at that. And I can imagine a lot has changed, especially when we're talking about the world of plumbing, right?
Correct. Raul, I like your analogy of the old lady because her vital signs aren't looking so great and need some upgrading. But however, you know, this cast iron has been here for, like you say, 95 years, so it's done its job well. And I think the challenge for us in the PVC game is to live up to that expectation with time.
I know we always incentivize to use good products, and one which stands out for me is Mali. I believe they offer a 50-year design guarantee. Can you talk to me more about this?
Yeah, I mean, there's various types of materials out there. You have UPVC, which is ours. It's a global material. It's used around the world. So yeah, PVC is probably the most economical product to use, most practical. So with PVC being lightweight, easy to use, user-friendly, installed by accredited plumbers, done properly with floor design, layouts, and you will have a system for another 95 years.
I love that we're talking about quality products. Johan, do you think that if we were to incorporate Mali and the entire system into these four new apartments, that we could potentially get another 95 years of life?
Well, I'm pretty sure that would be possible. With Mali's way of manufacturing pipe systems and PVC products, the longevity of having Mali on site would really extend the lifetime of this old lady standing right here with us. In the olden days, it used to be all outside. These days, less than 3% of your house is plumbed where you cannot see it. And you will not, and you want to put a bath on top of it that's worth 20,000 Rand, but you will not be able to get to those pipes again once you've concealed them. So using a quality product like Mali, it would really give you that reassurance of what you put into the ground, you don't need to look at it again.
Well, gents, it's a privilege and a pleasure to have you on board for this project. I know it's going to be absolute magic, and we know that the plumbing is going to be lasting at least another 95 years.
Mali Piping are a proud supplier to Buco, our hardware partner on My Design Rules. And with the work that lies ahead, our design duos will be making plenty of trips to their nearest store.
Hey there, design duos.
Hey.
My name is Lesego Moagi. I'm from Buco in Timber City, and welcome to our stores.
Thank you.
First and foremost, congratulations on making it to the final. Your designs were picked and I was one of the judges. And I must say, I'm really looking forward to seeing what you guys are going to produce over the next few weeks of My Design Rules. So you are now in Buco in Timber City. Think of this as your home away from home over the next few weeks as you navigate your way through awesome challenges and a lot of fun that we're going to have together. This is almost like a candy store for people that are handy, for people that want to get their hands dirty, and for people that are determined to build really cool possibilities.
There's so many different departments that we can definitely use for our apartment redesign, and we're so excited to get started.
We all know that anybody who's either building or renovating needs to have a budget and a plan that stick together really well. Now, I'm a practical guy, so I've made sure with our partners Capitec and other suppliers that you've each got a 100,000 Rand Buco account that you'll be using to draw down on over the next few weeks.
Awesome.
We love the Buco store. It's got everything we need. It's got nuts and bolts.
Paint colors.
And screws.
They've got everything.
Make sure to download the Buco Go app so that you can manage your accounts on your phones on the fly. Now guys, I must remind you, you need to use your budgets wisely. You've got 100,000 Rand as each duo to use over the next few weeks, but wait. There's a little bit extra. Our fantastic suppliers, Plascon and Durham, have also contributed, and your paint needs will be covered over and above your account.
Wow.
Thank you, Plascon.
Thank you, Durham.
So, with that being said, all the best as you head on to your challenges, and remember, I'll be watching you closely. Let's go and have a look around the store, see how we can spend it all. Let's go.
I noticed that Durham has a special variety of paints, which is the Habitat version, and that is quite exciting for us. I think that's one of the top products that they've got at the moment, and I think it's going to be a wonderful selection of colors that we can apply.
There's a wide variety of paints that you guys can choose from. If you're looking for a specific color or want to get that perfect shade, feel free to ask any of our paint technicians at our paint counter. And remember, if there's anything you don't know, just ask. So let's go. So, duos, lighting is one of the most underrated elements of any build or renovation. Using the right lighting, you could craft a completely different story to the same original space. So, between Eurolux and Radiant Lighting, they've offered their full catalog at your disposal. Please, guys, have a look at the displays and check out their catalog online.
We're really liking the lighting options that they have in terms of the pendants, in terms of the chandeliers, because, I mean, we have really tall walls, so we want to connect those walls with the lights.
Yeah, lighting is an important aspect in our design, and we're willing to play with lights again and make it a spatial environment within our design.
Okay, we've got power tools. Now, guys, this is kind of the fun part, but be mindful. Get your personal protective equipment first and ensure that you're doing the right things whenever you operate these heavy-duty machinery. Now, Ryobi has come on board, and they're going to be supplying all the power tools as well as the accessories that you're going to need as you go on with your challenges over the next few weeks.
So we're walking past the power tool section, and we saw some amazing machinery there. So this powerful drill, I think we're going to use that a lot.
You've all been given the tools you need to succeed. You all have a beautiful 100,000 Rand account from Buco. You've each downloaded your Buco Go apps on your phones, and you'll each have an opportunity to interact with the amazing people at our building materials counters at each store that you've been allocated. Guys, all the best for the challenges ahead, and good luck. Begin with Buco.
We'll see you again next week as our design duos race against the clock to complete their first room in the apartment. And remember, you too can win big with a cash prize of 5,000 Rand from Capitec. Good luck. To enter, let us know which small town in South Africa do you dream of owning a property in. Simply reply to the competition post on the My Design Rules social platforms, and don't forget to include the hashtag Capitec and the hashtag My Design Rules. You could be a winner.
My Design Rules is sponsored by Capitec. Better never rests.
Another feel-good production.